Hey everyone, it's Chaz. Welcome back to the channel, and in this video, we will be looking at Advent of Code 2022, Day 1. And we may only look at Part 1 in this video. We'll see how long it gets. Now, I'm not going to read the entire problem here. If you want to read the problem, you can just pause the video now. But basically, what's happening in this problem is we're given a list of numbers. They're in groups separated by blank lines. And what we want to do is for each group of values, find the sum of each group. And then out of all of these groups, find out which one has the maximum sum. Our little example here, the first group of numbers is the first three on top, 1,000, 2,000, and 3,000. We're going to set up a space for our sum and a space for the maximum. So that group has a sum of 6,000. We'll put that here, and we don't have a maximum just yet, so that group so far is automatically the max of 6,000. I go down to the next group, separated by a blank line. The sum of just one single value is just the value itself, 4,000. That's not greater than 6,000, so we'll leave our maximum the way it is. Go down to the next group of values, which is a 5,000 and a 6,000. The sum is 11,000. That's greater than the current maximum, so let's update our max. We go to the next group of values. This time there are three of them, 7,000, 8,000, and 9,000. The sum of that is 24,000. That's greater than our max, so let's update our max. And finally, the last group is just a single value, 10,000. So the sum is just the value itself, 10,000. That's not greater than 24,000, so we return our final answer, which is a maximum of 24,000. All right, so that's all well and good. It's pretty easy to understand what we have to do. The real challenge here is getting this to work in an IDE. But that's okay. That's what we're here for. So let's code some Java. All right, so this is where we left off on day zero. So I have my project over here. I named it Advent2022_YT. My project contains a source folder, and within that source folder, I have my main.java file. And I have another folder which I named resources. If you haven't made it this far and you're not sure how to get set up to this point, you should watch my day zero video on the initial setup, and I'll put a link to that in the description. So actually the first thing I'm going to do from here is get on the Advent of Code website. I'm going to go to day one, and I've already solved this problem under my account, so I'm just going to scroll to the bottom, and it says here to get my puzzle input. I'm just going to click on that. And everyone's puzzle input is going to be different, so you're not going to get the same input as me. Right-click and just save as, so that I can save this text file. I'm going to put it in the folder that I created, which was Advent2022_YT in the source folder. And here's that folder I created called resources. So I'm going to put it in that folder. And I'm not going to keep this default name. I'm going to make things a little easier on myself, and I'm just going to rename this. So I just named this input day one with dashes. I'm just going to hit save. And then one more thing I'm going to do before I leave this website is I'm going to scroll back up to this test input right here. I'm just going to select these and copy. I'm going to go to that folder that I created. And you can do it in IntelliJ. I'm just going to do it through Windows Explorer. But here's that folder for my project. Here's the source folder. And then resources. And I'm just going to create a new text document. I'm going to name this one test day one. We'll open that up. And then I'm just going to paste those values and then save. I'm doing this just because I want to test my code with a set of values where I already know what the answer is. This way, if something goes wrong, I can try to figure out why. Okay, so I'm back in IntelliJ. And if I now take this resources folder and open it up, I do have my two text files. I can double click this one. Those are my test values and then my main input file. So everything looks good. So what I'm now going to do is right click in this project. I'm going to choose new Java class, and I'm going to try to stay consistent with my naming as the days go by. So I'm going to name this one day1_2022. It creates my class. Within this class, I'm just going to create a method. Since I'm trying to find a maximum sum, I'm going to go public int. So I want to return an integer, and I'm just going to call it getMaxSum. And my method's going to take a string called filePath, and that's the variable I'm going to use for my input file. And since I just created a method that's supposed to return an int, just so Java doesn't get mad at me, I'm just going to create an int. Call it max sum. We'll just set it to 0 for now, and then we'll just return max sum. Now I'll go back into my main method. Now that I've created a method in my day one class, I can actually call it. So let's create an object first. We'll do day 1, 2022. You can name the object anything. I'll just go day 01 equals new day 1, 2022. Now that I have that object, I can use that to call the method. But first, I'll just set a variable that will represent the output of that method. So let's go int sum equals day 01 dot get max sum. And this is where we're going to have to put in that file path, which is going to be a string. And this is just where I'm going to type in the path to the text file that I'm going to use as my input. So that location is the source folder in the resources folder slash, and we'll do the test text file first. So that'll be testday01.txt. And now that I've created a variable, I can now output that using my print line. So system.out.println, and from now on, I'm actually just going to use the IntelliJ shortcut, system out, S out, like that. You'll see me sometimes use SOUF as well to do printf. In this case, we'll just do S out, and what will we print? We'll print the sum. And we can right away test that this is working, because in that getMaxSum method, all I did was return the number 1, so when I run this, I see my value of 0 right there. All right, now let's try to read that file. So for that to work, I'm going to have to use the file class and create a file object. So we'll go file equals new file. And then it's going to want to know which file. Well, I already set a variable called file path to represent the path to that file. So let's just use file path. And you can see already that Java is yelling at me, because in order for the file class to work, we're going to have to import it. So we'll come up here, we'll import java.io.file, and that'll make that error go away. And IntelliJ is pretty good about importing automatically. So going forward, I may not discuss the imports like array, ArrayList, etc., all the other ones that we might see along the way. Now, there is one more thing we're going to have to do. Because we are attempting to read a file, there's a possibility that the file might not be there, which means that our code could throw an exception. So we need to account for that. So here at the start of our method, I'm going to say throws file not found exception. And then you can see that Java is yelling at us. And when I come over here, I'm going to have the same problem where this exception is not handled. So the same thing here in my main method, I'm going to do throws file not found exception. And you can see that IntelliJ automatically imported that for me in both classes. Now, I already know that later on for Advent of Code, I'm going to need a more general exception than this called an IO exception. IO exceptions include the file not found exceptions. It's just a more general form of it. So right away, I'm just going to immediately change this from file not found exception to IO exception, because I know that's going to come up later. And then I'm going to do the same thing up here and change it. I don't have to change it in my day one class. Because the file not found exception extends the IO exception, it's okay to throw the file not found exception, even though the main method is expecting an IO exception. So back in our day one class, within the getMaxSum method, we have a file object to represent our text file. And now we're going to create a scanner. Scanner equals new scanner. And I know sometimes when you're doing like Java tutorials, the scanner will have system.in in the parentheses, but in this case, we're not using system.in. We're actually using that text file. So we created the file object. We named it file. So that's what we're going to put in here, just file. And the next thing, I need to create another integer. We have one to represent the max sum, but we don't have one to represent the current sum. So I'm going to have to create one of those. So we'll just go int, and I'll call it elf sum, because it's the sum of one individual elf. And for now, we'll set that equal to zero as well. And now down here, we're going to start our while loop. And we're going to go until we run out of lines in that text file. So while scanner dot has next line. And our text file is going to send us strings. Even though the file contains numbers, the Java scanner is going to interpret them as strings. So the first thing I'm going to do is just create a variable to hold that string. So we'll do string current num, and we'll do equals scanner dot next line. So at this point, our scanner has taken the first line of the text file and stored it in a variable called current num. And the strategy that I'm going to use here is if I go into my test file, what I'm going to do is I'll take each line in this text file and I'm going to attempt to turn it into an integer. For the numbers here, it's going to work just fine. But for the blank lines, it's not going to work. It's going to throw an exception. I'm going to take advantage of that exception to temporarily stop my code so I can check my sums. Let me show you what I mean. So I'm going to use a try block and a catch block. Try and catch. And we'll do elf sum, and we'll do plus equals. And it would be current num, except that current num is a string. So we're going to have to turn this into an int by using integer.parseInt. And as long as the text file has a number on that line, this block will work. And so what'll happen is my sum starts at zero. This line contains a number. My sum will increase to 1,000. This line contains a number. The sum will increase to 3,000. This line contains a number. My sum will increase to 6,000. This line does not contain a number. And this is going to throw a number format exception. So I'm going to catch that exception. Catch. Number format exception. I just have to name it something. We'll call it E. And when I catch that exception, I'm going to do two things. One, I'm going to check my current elf sum to see if it's now my maximum. So we'll take our variable max sum, and we'll find the max, so math.max, between the current elf sum and whatever the max sum is right now. And then once we're done with that, I'm going to take my elf sum and reset it back to zero. This will allow my text file to now go to the next line, and since the elf sum is back to zero when it adds 4,000, I'll actually get a sum of 4,000. So that code will continue until I get down here to the last line. This blank line will allow me to reset my elf sum to zero. This 10,000 will be read and added to the elf sum. Zero plus 10,000 is 10,000. But then there is no blank line after it. So this line is never going to be checked to see if it's actually my maximum. So I'm going to need to check this last line. And I know that an easy way to do it would be to just add another line to my text input, but honestly, I consider that cheating. However the text file appears, however it's given to us, that's how we're going to process it, no matter what. So I'm just going to type a quick comment. It has said that the loop ends before the last sum is checked, and that's why I'm checking the last sum right here. And so I can just do this same check. I'm just going to copy and paste. One last thing we should do, which is a good practice, is if you used a scanner, you should close that scanner just to avoid any memory issues as you continually run this program. We're already returning the max sum, and if we did everything correct, when I run this, I see 24,000 is the result, and if I go to my day one advent of code, check my test input, and it says that in the example above, I should get 24,000. So it looks like my code is about to work. Now, I've already solved this problem, so you could see that my puzzle answer is going to end up being 75501. So let's go back into IntelliJ, go to my main method, and instead of running the test text file, I'm actually going to run the input file. So let's change this to input. And I'm sure there's a better way to do this, but this is just the way I did it. When I first started doing Advent of Code, I didn't really know how to get this set up. So this is just the way that worked for me. If you have a better way, by all means, do it your way. But now when I run this file, you see I get 75501. So everything's good. All right, so that's it for day one, part one. I'm actually going to stop this video here and do part two in a future video. This way these videos don't get too long, because as we get through these Advent of Code days, oh boy, some of these problems are going to be really long. But yeah, that's it. If you have any comments about my approach, please put them in the comments. I'm always happy to learn, especially if you have a more efficient way to do this. I would love to hear it. And yeah, that's it. Like the video, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.